that there are patients that come to me and they can describe symptoms over the last couple of years. Some of the time they occur and then they resolve and then they come back and more in a more severe fashion. They, you know, then they start to get recognized with the disease. And then there are some patients where it really comes on very quickly over the course of a few weeks and a month. Very rarely, they might get exposed to a medication that worsens neuromuscular transmission. So there's some common antibiotics like Levaquin that can do that. They have a bronchitis, they take the Levaquin, and all of a sudden, you know, they're slurring their speech, they get double vision, their eyelids are drooping, and so that can come on quickly. But in terms of recognition, you know, a key aspect to recognizing myasthenia is that it involves the ocular muscles preferentially. So at least half of patients right at symptom onset will have either a droopy eyelid that comes and goes during the day, or double vision that fluctuates, and they can, droopy eyelids, ptosis can come in combination with double vision, but that's a key component. So a lot of patients will present to an ophthalmologist. I would hope most ophthalmologists would recognize this condition, ocular myasthenia, as, you know, something that's drummed into ophthalmologists. The challenge there is its fluctuating nature. So a patient can develop a droopy eyelid. It's 3 p.m. After a, you know, rough day in the office, and they may have a little bit of blurring of vision. They make their ophthalmology appointment, see the ophthalmologist 8 a.m., and they have no findings and they don't have any symptoms. And so that does make the diagnosis more difficult. And certainly I've had patients, and this is true, that the typical patient needs to wait 9 months and go through three physicians to finally come to a diagnosis. But to your question, the key is the identification of eye muscle problems, and then that can be alone or in concert with just generalized weakness. And when I say generalized weakness, that can involve slurring of speech, difficulty swallowing and chewing, and the severity can vary. It can be relatively mild. And again, that makes the recognition more difficult as opposed to the much more severely weak. And it can mimic other disorders. That's another challenge. I had a patient who had acute double vision, and it's just one certain direction. They had diabetes, and so the ophthalmologist said quite logically, well, this looks like a diabetic sixth nerve palsy, which will get better. And you know, that's not, you know, an unreasonable thought. Only after several months, when the double vision changed in its quality and some eyelid droop developed, was the myasthenia recognized. So, you know, in terms of, you know, reaching out to patients as well as primary care physicians who are going to be, you know, on the front lines, it's that ocular involvement as well as the kind of fluctuating nature of the symptoms. And even when a patient may be fine in the office, to consider the diagnosis of myasthenia.